Let's do question number fourth. Given that HCF, this in bracket is written are the two given numbers. HCF of 306 and 657 is 9. You have to find the LCM of 306 and 657. That is, these are the two given numbers of which you are given the HCF and you have to find the LCM. So what are you given? First number you are given is 306 and second number you are given with 657. HCF is given to you, that is given 9. You have to find its LCM. So LCM is question mark. You will use the formula you have been told earlier. I hope you all remember that formula, that LCM multiplied by HCF would be equals to the product of the two given numbers. You are clear with the two numbers given here, that is 306 and 657. Now LCM you have to find out, so you will write it to be LCM or you can write it to be X as well. HCM is 9 is equals to, product means multiply of two numbers, that is 306 multiplied by 657. These are the two given numbers and we'll multiply it. Now you can find it with the formula like you are finding the value of X as well, or you will keep LCM here and you will take 9 to the other side, and if this is multiplying here on that side it will get divide. So LCM is equals to 306 into 657 upon 9. Now you can reduce it. I know you all remember the divisibility rules as well. So both are divisible by 9 as the sum of 3 plus 6 is 9. So 9 threes are 27, 3 left 36, then 9 fours are 36. So it is 34 multiplied by 657. That would be 22,338. Don't forget to put the comma. So your LCM is 22,338. Question number 5 says that check whether 6 raised to the power n can end with digit 0 for any natural number n. It says for any power of 6, n could be any number, any power of 6. If we are solving it, the value of 6 raised to the power n would end with the digit 0. It means the unit digit of the number after solving 6 raised to the power n should be 0 only. Suppose if you are taking 6 raised to the power 3, that 6 into 6 into 6. So when you will multiply 6 into 6, that would be 36, and 36 into 6 would be 216. That ends with 6. The question wants the digit should be ending with 0. For that it says if a number ends with 0, for that prime factors must be 2 into 5. Because if we want 10 at the end, it wants 2 into 5 to be its factors. If it is making one pair of 2 into 5, then it will be making 10. If there are two pairs of the factors 2 into 5, then it will be making 100, means 2 zeros. And if it is 3 pairs, then it will be 3 zeros, that is 1000 in 2 into 5. 6 raised to the power n. We will be taking the factors of 6 for finding the value of 6 raised to the power n, because n could be any value. We can write 6 as prime factorization to be 2 into 3, because 6 is 2 into 3 and n will remain n same as its power. 6 is equals to 2 multiplied by 3, but we want it to be 2 into 5. Other than that there could be any number, but we want 2 and 5 for sure, because 2 and 5 only be making a 0 for making it 10. But it is not there, 2 is there but 5 is not there. So 6 raised to the power n cannot be end with digit 0. Why? Because its prime factors, that is 2 into 3, do not contain the pair of 2 into 5. We can have more pairs of 2 into 5, but one pair is necessary to have 0 as its unit digits, or you call it as 1's place.
then only the any power of n could be ending with 0. Is that clear? Its prime factors do not contain pair of 2 into 5, so it's not possible having 0 in the end.
Question number 6 says, explain why 7 multiply 11 multiply 13 plus 13 and 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus 5 are composite numbers. For this question, you must recall the definitions of prime numbers and composite numbers. What are prime numbers? Prime numbers which are having only two factors, basically 1 and the number itself. And composite numbers are the numbers which are having more than two factors, that is more than the number 1 and itself, it has some other factors as well. It can be observed that 7 multiply 11 multiply 13, you will see, we'll solve this first, not completely, but partially we'll solve it. I have told you this many a times that whenever there is a sign of plus or minus, there our terms are changed. You remember the word terms? So here the plus sign is here only. So this is one term, 7 into 11 into 13, and the other term is 13. So we can take out 13 as the common part of this sum. So we'll write 13 into, I'll rub this because it's not visible otherwise. 13 agar humne common liya, so we are left inside with 7 into 11 out of the first term, and from the second term 1 is left because 13 ones are 13, we have already taken 13 outside. So there is no need to solve it further. We'll solve it, but from here it is very clear that if this number is multiplied with 13, so it means it is nowhere a prime number, because this number is multiplied with 13 also and some other number also. We'll solve it in next step, it will be more clear to you. Now it will become 13 into 7 multiply 7. If we take 7 into 7, it would be 77 plus 1 is 71 plus 7 is 78. So 13 multiply 78. From this, you nowhere need to multiply in this question, no need to multiply 13 into 78. Why? Because this number is having the factor, whatever the number comes, that number would be having 13 as its factor and 78 also as its one of the factor. So if that number is having more than two factors, that is number 1 and itself, it is showing two factors clearly here, and 78 is an even number which will be having more factors. So it's nowhere a prime number, it's a composite number, because you can write 78 to be 13 into 6, so it is having 13 and 6 here, two factors. Further, if you will split, 6 is having 2 and 3 as the factors. So the given expression has 6 and 13 as its factor, therefore it is a composite number. This you can find out from this step also. It's not necessary that you will do it till here, because it is clearly visible from 13 into 78 as well that it is a composite number. Similarly, we will be doing the next number. See, that is 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus 5. What are the two terms given here? The first one term is till plus sign. Till here, it is the first term. This is the sign of addition. It shows the different two terms. So, it is first term is also having 5 and second term is also having 5. So, we can take 5 as to be the common factor. If we'll take 5 common, we are left behind with 7 multiply 6 multiply 4, because 5 we have already taken. Multiply 3 multiply 2 multiply 1 plus, we have taken this 5 already outside, so we are left behind with 1. 5 multiply, when you will multiplying these numbers, you are getting 1008
plus 1. That will give you 1009 into 5. So this number is having two factors, 5 and 1009, two factors other than the number 1 and itself. So it is a composite number. 1009 can be factorized further also. Therefore, 5 into 109 or whatever this expression was, it's a composite number because it is having already given two factors, 5 and 1009. There can be some twisted questions similar to this question that I will give you in assignment. I want you to try that once and then that I'll explain you further. Some twisted in this type of question, though it was very simple. Or in twist somewhere you can be like, suppose it is 5 here and in this expression board exam can have this kind of question, like if it is 5 here, other than 5 we can take some other value. For example, if you will be taking 8, but 8 won't be here, so we can split that 8 into 4 into 2. So if we are splitting that 4 into 2, so it is here 4 into 2, or might be one of the number could be here 4 into 2, then you can take that one number to be common. Means whatever term you are having a single number or two numbers and they are not matching, then you can split this type of term in those numbers out of which you can take any one common factor from the first expression. Then that will be the twisted question. I hope this question is very much clear to you. So you can note it down in your copy as it is. This is done in the board here. Exercise 1.2, question number 7. There is a circular path around a sports field. Sonia takes 18 minutes to drive one round of the field while Ravi takes 12 minutes for the same. Suppose they both start at the same point and at the same time and go in the same direction. After how many minutes will they meet again at the starting point? Now listen to this question very carefully. It's a very easy question, but there is a trick behind this question. He is saying that the path is circular in shape. So if the path is circular in shape, this is the path they have to move around. Sonia is a girl who is taking 18 minutes to drive one round of the field while Ravi takes 12 minutes for the same. They are moving around this circular path and they need 18 minutes or 12 minutes to complete this round. So it means Ravi is taking lesser time than Sonia. Moving ahead in the question, first understand the concept of the question very carefully. There is a concept hidden behind this question. Suppose they both start at the same time, same point, and at the same time and go in the same direction. He is saying they are starting from the same point, they are at the same time and also in from the same direction. Same point, same time and also the same direction. The question he is asking is, after how many minutes will they meet again at the starting point? Suppose you will take this to be the point. This is the point from where they are starting and they are taking the full round of this path. There are two persons, one is Ravi and one is Sonia. This is Ravi and this is Sonia. Now they both are taking rounds of this path. So in one round, Sonia is taking 18 minutes. So in two rounds, she will be taking 36 minutes. In three rounds, she will be taking 54 minutes. Similarly, that is the multiple of 18. That is the table of 18. So Sonia will be taking how many minutes for the different rounds? So as many rounds keep on going, she will be taking the multiples of 18 to complete. That is that what we will get after taking the multiples of 18. That is the minutes she is taking to complete the rounds. Similarly, Ravi is taking 12 minutes for one round. So for two rounds, he will be taking 24 minutes. Then for 3 rounds, he will be taking 36 minutes. And it will keep on going. As the number of rounds will increase, their time will be increasing. And that increased time will be the multiples of this number. So the point is, where they will be meeting again would be the common multiple, the same multiple which they are taking together. That means we have to find the multiples of 18 as well as the multiple of 12. And we have to find the same multiple. And which same we want, which equal multiple we want. We need to find the multiple of 18 as well as the multiple of 12. But which same multiple we want? We want the smaller multiple. We want the similar multiple, which is the smaller one. So smaller one means the lowest one. What does this mean? We have to find the LCM of 18 and 12. I hope you understood that what do we want. We want LCM, but the question behind this I want to explain. I know you all can find the LCM, that's not a big deal. I want you to understand that why we want the LCM. Because I hope you understood. I'll take a quick recap. Sonia will be taking 18 minutes. So we will what time will take she needs for 2 rounds, 3 rounds, 4 rounds. That would be the multiples of 18. And Ravi, how many minutes he wants for 2 rounds, 3 rounds, 4 rounds and so on. That would be the multiples of 12. And wherever they are meeting again would be the same multiple of 18 and 12, the same which is in the same also, and the smaller one also, that is the lowest, that is small. Common means same, and M is multiple. All right, going ahead for the solution. Sonia takes 18 minutes, Ravi takes 12 minutes. So you can see that Ravi is taking the lesser time than Sonia, though it does not matter much. So what do you need to find? They will meet again at the same time, would be equal to the same point or at the starting point. This is denoted with this point S or R. That would be the LCM of 18 and 12. So it is very simple for you. 18, you can write the prime factorization. 18 would be equal to 2 multiplied 3 multiplied by 3. That is 2 3 are 6, 6 3 are 18. So that could be written as 2 into 3 raised to the power 2. Because for finding LCM or HCF, we need the power, the prime factorization numbers in powers, so that we can find its highest degree. 12 can be written as 2 multiplied 2 multiplied by 3. That is 2 to the 4 multiplied 3 is 12. That we can write it in the form 2 raised to the power 2 multiplied by 3. So LCM of 12 and 18 is equals to 2 multiplied 2. Why? Because in 18 and 12, it is 2 also and 3 also. So the highest degree of 2 is in 12, that is 2 raised to the power 2. We'll write 2 raised to the power 2. And 3 is 3 raised to the power 2 in 18 and 3 in 12. So we will take this, we'll take this value of 3 raised to the power 2 and this value of 2 raised to the power 2. So it would be 2 raised to the power 2 into 3 raised to the power 3, 2. So 2 raised to the power 2 is 2 into 2, that is 4. And 3 raised to the power 2 is 3 into 3, that is 9. So 4 9s are 36. So the LCM of 12 and 18 is 36. It means that Ravi and Sonia will be meeting after 36 minutes at the same point again. I hope this question is clear to you properly. So here finishes our this exercise. 1.2. You all can do this exercise in the notebook as in the format written here in the notebook. But be careful, might be I have not written this equals to sometimes on board here in proper format. In all equals to I want in the same line. Proper, neat and clear, clean handwriting should be there in your notebook. And as you know what I want in the writing, starting point should be the same. No rough work in between here. Either do the rough work on the right hand side or at the bottom of the page. So be careful how to do the manner. Keep reminding the manner of doing the work I have explained you from your previous classes. Thank you so much.